today I will discuss with you with the physics chapter, light. It is very important chapter, I think, so you must aware about it. So first of all, students, I want you must interact with me and let me know, according to you, what is light? According to you, what is the correct definition of light? What do you think what is light actually is? May I aware how much you know about the light? So that's why I will start from that much basics. Okay, lights are rays. It is a source of energy. Great. A source of energy, it is a form of energy. Very good. Yes, you all are right that light is a form of energy. Definitely correct, bacha. Okay. Do you know what is the nature of light, bacha? Light is the emission of photons sent in the form of rays, which is form of energy. Yes, Angad, you are correct. So yes, students, do you know nature of light? What is the nature of light according to you? You all are correct that it is a source of light. It helps us to see. Yes, it is correct. Do you know what is the nature of light? Very good, Angad. Travels in a straight line. Why? Very good. Then what we call it then? If it travels in a straight line, what is a phenomena in science we call it? Very good, actually, it's wave. Very good. Arush, it's not ray. There is some other term we use. Okay, I will let you know, bacha. Nature of light is dual nature. It has two nature. One is wave and other is particle, bacha. Other is particle. It travels in a straight light. That phenomena in science is called particle, bacha. Okay, and wave means the nature of divergence, rectilinear propagation. Yes, Sanchi, we can say this, no issues. Now let me know, bacha, do you know what is wave? How we can say a light is a wave, beta? Any idea why we called as light is a wave? Because light is diverging. Okay, first of all, I will clear one thing with you, bacha. Do you know the meaning of diverging and converging? Diverging. Okay, great, Ritik, if you know, very good. Converging, very good. So, bacha, diverging is what? A wave. Like when we switch on the light in our room, right? The light present in our whole room. That is called a wave nature. That is a wave nature of light that is diverge in all the directions. Right? But if you will see the laser light, have you ever seen the laser light? Laser beam, right? It is always travel in a straight line, always. Yes, that is called converging light. So a light have a property of dual nature. It will show you a wave nature along with a particle nature. So it's very much important for you all that this must be clear in your mind. Light is a form of energy. Its nature is wave as well as particle. How it behaves like a wave? Because it's diverged in the room. And how it behaves like a converge? A simple example is beam of light, that is laser light. Is it clear with you all till now? What is light and nature of light? Any doubt in your mind, please let me know. Okay, Ritek. Okay, Namam. Okay, great. So, bacha, I will let you know further. Like you are telling, with the light, you are able to see the object. Will you please let me know how you are able to see the object? Suppose this is an object, any object, and this is your eye. How you are able to see it? Very good, Lakshay. It is through reflection of light. Very good. Reflection of light. Very good. Very good, Ritek. Great. So, first of all, light falls on object. It will again goes to eye. So in this way, you are able to see the object. Very good, Shruti. Light gets reflected to my eyes. Great. So again, I will let you one thing, bacha. Suppose this is a surface. Any surface you can take, right? And light falls on it. Suppose a light falls on it, right? And it will get reflected. It will again get reflected with it. So this phenomenon is called reflection of light. Is it clear with you all? This phenomena is called reflection of light. Now, bacha, when there is a reflection of light, yes, bacha, every object is reflecting. Definitely, that's why our eyes is able to see each and everything, because every object have its capacity to reflect back the light, right? So, bacha, the ray which firstly fall on the surface, which we call is that ray. Name of that ray, bacha? which falls on the surface first. Incident ray, Arushi, very good. That is called incident ray. Very good. Okay, the ray which bounces back. Very good. That is called reflected ray. Yes, great. Now you are talking about some students like, ma'am, angle of incidence. How we are able to make angle of incidence here? Do you know how we are able to make? Yes, very good, Sanchi, great. So we are able to make here an angle by drawing a normal line. By drawing a normal ray, bachcha, very good. While we are able to drawing a normal, right? So now in this way, we are able to make what? A normal. Yeah, by making an angle of 90 degree, you are right. Correct? Wait for a second. You are correct that by making an angle of 90 degree, you are able to make what? You are able to make a cone, a perpendicular. Yes. So now, bacha, do you know what is angle of incidence here? Angle of incidence. So, bacha, angle of incidence is this. The angle formed between incident ray and the normal ray. The angle formed between the incident ray and the normal ray. Very good. That is called angle of incidence. Great. So, what is angle of reflection now? According to you, what is the angle of reflection? Very good. Between the reflected ray and the normal ray. Yes, great. Ritik, good. Aditya, good. So, is it clear? Reflection of light, incident ray, reflected ray, normal ray, angle of incidence, angle of refraction. Any doubt? Clear? Great, bacha. So, I will again repeat. Is it clear? Incident ray, which falls on the surface, it bounces back. That is called reflected ray. Again, we will draw a perpendicular at the center to make angle incidence and angle reflection. Is it clear with everyone? Any doubt till now? Any student have? Please let me know. Now, students, we are making this diagram, right? In a very simple way. Now, if we have to perform this experiment, we can do it in our homes by using a torch. You must have a mirror. You put light with the help of a torch and you are able to see incident ray and as well as reflected ray. No, bacha. That is angle incidence. But when we don't have the number of angle, like when we don't have the correct number, like it is 30 degree, it is 40 degree, we'll write it as theta. When we don't have the value of that angle, then we write it as a theta, bacha. Okay, Ritik, great. So this experiment you can do at your homes. It's really easy experiment and you will understand the incident ray and the reflected ray. Is it clear with everyone? Any doubt? Any student have till now? So that I will move further. Clear? Now, bacha, if you know laws of reflection, anyone from your side, there are two laws of reflection. Very good, Angad, great. You all are really intelligent, right? Angle of incidence is always equal to angle of refraction. Very good. And the second law is incident ray. Incident ray. Reflected ray and the normal ray. And the normal ray. No, bacha, Gaurish, that is not the law of reflection. That is a property of light, bacha, that it is traveling a straight line. Okay? Incident ray, reflected ray and normal ray lie on the same plane, beta. Lie on the same plane. Is it clear with you? The two laws, bacha, if you remember this figure. This incident ray, normal ray and the reflected ray all lying on the same plane. And angle of I is always equal to angle of R. Now let me know. If in question it is given that angle I equals to 30 degree, you must angle R. What is the value of angle R, bacha? Very good, Lakshya, Ritik, great. Now if angle I is 90 degree, what is the angle of R? Very good, Shriyesh, I think so. Angad, very good. It's zero. That is a concept which I want to teach you, bacha. Like, beta, this is a surface, right? If any ray comes at 90 degree angle, it will go reflect back in the same direction. And that way, no reflection takes place. No reflection of light takes place, bacha. So angle becomes zero. Okay, bache. So the angle becomes zero. Ritik, in this case, there is no normal. I will again repeating you, that is a very interesting concept, because bacha, when the surface having a perpendicular light, right, it will not reflect back. In simple words, when a light falls at 90 degree, it will never form any angle of incidence, any angle of reflection, and both our angle are 0 degree. Any doubt till now, bacha? Because these kinds of question you will get in a lumpy art. Yes, you are right. Great, bacha. Now there are two types of reflection we have. The first is mirror reflection. The second is diffused reflection. Okay, Mikul, what's your doubt? Please let me know. Yes, Sanji. Yes, Sangar. Ritik, ma'am, is the light coming in 180 degrees? Yes, bacha, definitely. Like I will let you know. I will show a diagram. No issues. Like, bacha, suppose this is a surface. If light comes here, you are telling about 180 degree, right? Then it will not fall into the surface. It must be fall between the 1 degree to tilted about 179 degree, right? Because when it is 180 degree, right, in the same way like in the 90 degree, you are unable to get the angle. Because if 90 degrees here, 180 degrees here, again what will happen? It reflect back with same. Let me know your doubts, bacha, in the chat box so that I will solve your doubt. Yes, you are right, Amritya. The laws are the same for each reflection. Am I right? Yes, bacha, you are right. Okay, Ritik, great if you got it. Any other doubt any other student have? Ma'am, if the angle of incidence is greater than 90 degree, then also will be there no reflection? No, Mikul. If the angle of incidence, suppose it is this, it is 110, then again the reflection will take place, bacha. That is not the case. Only when the ray of light is perpendicular to the surface, at that time angle of incidence is zero. Okay, Namang, I will again explain you. No issues, bacha. So there are two laws, Namang. First is angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection. Why this happens? Because we draw a normal into it, right? And second law is what? That both, all the three rays, even it is incident ray, normal ray, reflected ray, they all lie on the same plane, bacha. Lakshit, that is not a case actually, that it is always less than 90, because sometimes the surface has more light also. I am giving you a simple example, like you switch on in your room, right? It will reflect all the object of your room, right? They are not following that less than 90 degree will only form the angles. Okay, Arushi, write your doubt, bacha. Thank you, Amritya. Thank you for your comment. So, Lakshit, I hope it is clear, bacha. The thing is that before less than 90 degree, you are easily correctable. That before 90 degree, you are able to get the angle of incidence, angle of reflection. But when there is a large room, right, at that time, what will happen? The single tube in your room, the single bulb, CFL in your room, provide light to all the objects. Okay. Arushi, if the incident ray 90, so reflective ray. Definitely, Arushi, I am telling you, when the light perpendicular to the surface, then the angle of incidence and angle of reflection must be zero. Great. Okay, bacha, got it. Lakshit, great. Any other doubt, ma'am? Will the reflected ray always be on the right of the incident ray? Definitely, Aditya, definitely. Because reflected ray bounces back, bacha. Right? Incident ray come first and it bounces back. That become the reflected ray. Great, Arushi. Great, Namang. Any other doubt any student have? Ma'am, why is the like a laser light go converging in the normal light bulb? Ritik, that I am telling you. The thing is that, bacha, because light have two natures, right? Laser light is a particle. If you are able to see, I will show you with a diagram. Like if you see a CFL bulb, in this there is a ligament. It will provide this type of light, diverging. But if you see the laser light better, it have a just small point, a small, very small, from where the light comes. So that is why it shows particle nature. Sanchi, reflected ray never ever become the incident ray. Because bacha, the thing which reflect back, it will never fall the incident category. Because incident ray is that ray which comes first to the object, and reflected ray is that ray which goes from the object to the observer. Is it clear, the doubt? Ritik, is it clear beta with you? Sanchi, is it clear? So may I move further? Great, Ritik, if it is clear. That's why in the starting thing I told you wave and particle nature. Because this concept must be clear in your mind. Okay, great. So bacha, there are two types of reflection according to the surface. If the surface is plain, if the surface is polished, if it's plain, then it shows regular reflection. If you are able to see in this figure. If the surface, Amrita, let me know your doubt, bacha, no issues. If the surface is non-smooth, right? Yeah, Shriyesh, you're right. So this is called irregular reflection. Very good. I hope till now it is clear with you all. Any doubt any student have, please let me know. Any doubt any student have till now, bacha, please let me know so that I will explain you, then I will move further. Is there is black sponge, will it reflect? I will let you know. If there is a black sponge, bacha, right? Totally black sponge, then it will reflect, but a little bit light. It will reflect, but a very small angle is reflected. You may do this activity at your home. Take a black sponge, switch on the light, and you will see a little bit reflection. Yes, you are right. But still, they absorb the light. But if the sponge have a little bit harder place anywhere, it will reflect back at that time. Any other doubt any student have? Clear with the concept? Reflection of light, laws of reflection, wave nature of light, and types of reflection. Any doubt, beta? Ma'am, if there is reflected rays fall on another plane mirror, so it can be incident ray, right? Bacha, again, I will tell you, yeah, definitely if there is a medium, right, if there is any other medium between the reflected ray and the incident ray, then definitely it will become incident. If there is any object which doesn't reflect light, will it become invisible? Yes, Mikul, definitely, bacha. If any, like, you know that there are many objects in our locality, right? If I talk about microscopic organisms, amoeba, you are unable to see amoeba. The reason behind, they are not reflecting the light. Yes, Amritya, I am giving you the example of amoeba. You have never ever seen amoeba. You only seen amoeba in your slides, in your notebooks, in your books. The image is only clear because amoeba never reflect the light. Is it clear? No, Ritik, every object reflects light. You're right, but mostly, I will say you 90% object on this universe reflect light, but still there are few sub objects like microscopic organisms, dust particles, they don't reflect light. Yes, you are right, Priyas. Very good. Yes, very good, Sanji. How we are able to see in microscope? Bacha, because microscope have a lens. Microscope have a lens which makes is magnified, and when the image is magnified, then it will reflect light, bacha. That is why we are able to see. Amritya, that is a different topic. Like refraction is different. Today we are discussing about only reflection, so we will must be there. Otherwise, it is a really huge topic. Is it clear till now? Any student have any doubt? Please let me know. Any doubt? Any query till now, bacha? You have. Great, bacha. If it is clear, it is good. Now I will show you a video to clear the concept more. Bending of light when it goes from. Yes, Angad, you are right, but I will discuss with you in further days. Okay. See this video. If you have any doubt, please let me know. Okay. What is not clear to you, bacha? Please let me know. Gar, what is not clear to you? Any doubt? So that I will again explain you. Yes, Gar, what's your doubt? But I will again explain. Naman, you will get assignments and today's class notes on your WhatsApp. Girl, will you please let me know your doubt? Which concept I will again repeat? Okay, I will play the video. After that, you will let me know and I will again explain. Okay? You must write at that time if there is any issue you have.
Probably say it's the eyes that help us to see the objects around us. But will our eyes be able to see these objects in dark? No, we need light to see things. Without light, we cannot see the objects. But where is this light coming from? This light is coming from this source, which is a fluorescent bulb. You see that this bulb is emitting its own light. The objects which emit their own light are called luminous objects. Can you give me any other examples? Incandescent light bulb, the sun, the stars are also luminous objects. What about objects such as this table and chair? Do they emit their own light? No, these objects do not emit their own light. Such objects are called non-luminous. Almost everything around us is non-luminous. Objects made up of wood, plastic, cotton, metal are all non-luminous. What about the moon and the planets? They are also non-luminous. But if the moon is non-luminous, then how come we're able to see it at night? The answer to this is reflection of light. The reason we're able to see any non-luminous objects around us is because of the reflection of light. Reflection of light can simply be referred to as change in direction of light or bouncing of light from some surface. Just like the ball bounces from the ground, light reflects off from a smooth surface. Let me try to explain this in a simple way. The light from the source strikes the object and bounces off from its surface. And when this light reaches our eyes, we see that object. And this is how we see non-luminous objects. When the object is kept in front of the mirror, its image is formed in it. But will we be able to see the image in the dark? No, we won't. So the formation of the image is also due to reflection of light. Let this object be our human body, so at the same time, we are looking at the image. First, tell me, is our body a luminous or a non-luminous object? Well, it's non-luminous. Human body cannot emit its own light. So the light from the source is first incident on the human body. It gets reflected from it, and this reflected light strikes the mirror. This light is further reflected from the surface of the mirror and reaches our eyes. This is how we are able to see our image. Now, obviously, this is not the exact picture of the happenings. I just wanted to give you the intuitive feeling into how this happens. There are a lot of subtleties involved which we will learn in our higher grades.
Any doubt till now any student have, bacha? So that I will again explain you each and everything. Any doubt, any query any student have? Yes, there is a question like there are some rays of light which affects our eyes. Yes, that are UV rays. We call it as ultraviolet rays, X-rays. The thing is that, bacha, in that rays are too high intensity that it affects our eyes. Even it affects our cells, bacha. Cells of the body. In our body, cancer is formed due to these UV rays, due to these X-rays. So that is why, bacha. Yes, Angad, we can say the correct word, apart from frequency, is intensity of light is so high that our body is not adaptable to that intensity, bacha. Any other doubt, bacha, or may I move to the next topic? No, Ritik, there is only one ray of a light. It will form multiple rays also, but mostly it is one ray we are able to make. But yes, Ritik, when we are making ray diagrams in this chapter, then we need to draw two lights because we are making it what? Manually. Okay, Naman, you are getting bored. Okay, Mata, great. If no is out. The next is, bacha, very interesting. That is formation of image in a plane mirror, bacha. Actually, this topic is really very important. The reason behind this, in this topic, there are many ray diagrams. If you are able to understand these ray diagrams, you can easily do all the numericals. You have a knowledge. Like, if the object is present as focus, where will be the images formed. That all concept must be clear if you are able to clear this concept. If we place mirror on either sides, will it become uncountable? Definitely, Mukul, because there are two mirrors, then light will reflect again and again, then it will again form. Multiple image. Okay, bacha, may I start with this topic or you have any other doubt? Any other doubt if you have, please let me know. Okay, Arushi, great. Garb, you have a doubt, I think so. Will you please let me know so that I can explain you before moving further? Okay, great. So, bacha, you know what is a plane mirror. Anyone from your side, give me an example of a plane mirror. Okay, Akul, great. Car mirror. No, bacha. Car with, okay. Shaving mirror. Okay, ma'am, a mirror which is plain. Very good answer, bacha. Great. This is a great definition of plain mirror. No, bacha, Shivesh, shaving mirror is not a plain mirror. Ma'am, can you please tell me about the assignment or not, sir? Yeah, Priyas, like today we did this topic, right? After that, you must get the notes of this class. Right, you will get some questions to solve, so you may remember that each and every concept is clear in your mind or not. Sanchi, looking mirror. Yeah, this is a correct answer. Looking mirror is a plane mirror. Okay, when you see yourself in front of a mirror, when you observe yourself in front of a mirror, what changes you observe? Let me know first. What changes you will observe, bacha, when you observe yourself in a mirror? I think so. Everyone must observe themselves in a mirror for 5 to 10 minutes in a day, maybe. So what do you observe, bacha? Laterally inverted. Great. Ma'am, reverse. Great. Very good. The right is left and left is right. Great. So bacha, why this has happened? Lateral inversion. Yeah, you're right. Why this will happen, bacha? Do you think that why our left side become right and right side become left? Yes, it's called lateral inversion, but beta, it is called reflection of light. This is because of reflection of light, beta. If you will able to see this diagram here, this is a plane mirror, bacha. Okay? And this is an object. Light falls on object and again reflect to wave. It becomes incident to plane mirror, right? Again, it will get back to our eyes. Right, and then the correct image is formed behind the mirror, bacha. Great, Ritik. Very good. The correct image is formed here behind the mirror, bacha. That is why that image become laterally inverted. Great, very good, Angad. Very good, Shriyesh. Very good. Yes, Angad, you are right. In concave mirror, this will happen definitely. But bacha, in concave mirror, this will happen only in the case when the object is very close to the concave mirror. But in the case of plane mirror, even you are very far from the mirror, even you are very close to the mirror, the image will always form inverted. Yeah, Shriyesh and Angad, you are right. No, convex mirror never form inverted image. But sometimes due to intensity of object, it will happen also. But bacha, concave mirror form laterally inverted image only in that condition when the object is too close to the mirror, right? But when it happens in all F1 and 2-1, Angad, not in all, not because bacha, you are not be confusing between the lenses and mirror, I think so. Because in lenses case, you must have F1 and 2F1, because in the mirror case, you don't have focus 1, focus 2-1, nothing. Yes, you are right, Arushi, great. Yes, Ritik, you are right. They are talking about lens. Yeah, Angad. Don't be confused with that, bacha, because there is so much confusion between mirror and lenses. We will definitely study about each and everyone with a proper knowledge, right? With the proper basics. So today, I think so, it must be clear in your mind, like how our right become left and left become right when we are observing ourselves in a mirror. Is it clear? Is it clear, bacha? Any doubt till now you have? Great, bacha. Great. So I will show this thing with the help of a video also, so that this is an activity, bacha. You must try this activity after this class and you learn number of things if you do this activity after this class. This will clear your all the doubts regarding this topic if you have. Okay, so must watch this. Must be. Is it clear with everyone till now? Okay, Ritik. Now what will happen? You must have a torch with you. You must have a torch with you, Pacha. Right? And when you on this torch, what you will observe? This is what nature of light? A particle or a wave? Through this activity, which nature of light is observing? Great Ritik, great Naman Angad. I'm very happy that this concept is clear in your mind. Great. So, bacha, this is an activity. If you are able to see here, bacha, in this condition, when you tilt your torch, your observation will also change. Great Lakshmi. Reflection of light, bacha, and all the concept in clear in your mind then. Okay, Angel, I will explain, bacha. Okay, no issues, beta. I explain till now, bacha, that light have a nature of wave, no Ritik, and a particle. Wave is what? Diverging, bacha. Yes. Yes, Ritik, no need to say sorry. Diverge. And particle is of converging nature, bacha. Diverging means like angel, if you are able to see in this diagram, beta, what you will observe, the lights are diverging all the direction. The lights are diverging. That is called a wave nature, bacha. But if I will give you an example of laser light, a beam of light, beta, in this, light will not split, light will not diverge. So that is called the particle nature. Angel, is it clear with you, beta? Or may I again explain this thing to you? Yes, Ritik, you are right. Great. Clear, bacha, Angel? Okay, Naman. Any doubt any student have? Now I will check, bacha. Is it clear with you or not? Okay, Angel, great. Yeah, Akul, I will again explain, beta. Light have a nature, right? It have a nature of wave and it also have a nature of particle, bacha. How we know that light is a wave nature? When it diverge, bacha, I am giving you a simple example. Switch on a light on your room, in your room, right? In your home, in your room, the light will scatter all around the room because of its wave nature. But if you see the laser light, right? Laser red beam light, if you are able to see, it will always go to a straight line. With a very spot in it. That is called a particle nature, bacha. Right, Akul, is it clear? further we can define it is like that wave which diverge. Like if the light is here, light source is here, it will diverge. But if I talk about converging, bacha, it is only through this. It will like this. It will like this. Great, Akul, if it is clear. Now I will test your knowledge with a small quiz, bacha. Yes, Amritya, definitely, bacha. Okay, Angel, we are covering today like reflection of light, laws of reflection, image formed by plane mirror, right? Okay, Angel, no issues. So I started with the light and completed till image formed with the plane mirror, Angel. So this is a quiz and I want everyone must participate so that I must be aware. Like, what is your knowledge? Ritik, wait for a minute, bacha. On which theory nature of light depends upon? Wave theory, particle theory, both A and B and only A. Great. You are intelligent one. So bacha, it's both wave as well as particle, beta. Ritik, good, great. Next question is, why light is said to have a dual nature? Great, Shreyash, great, very good. Very good, Aditya, great. And I hope this concept is clear in your mind right now. Great, good. Okay, which object doesn't reflect more light? Third, very good. Intelligent student at C, great. Okay, the next is, name a metal which is best reflector of light, which are gold, silver, iron, magnesium. Okay, there are some confusion, bacha. So silver is a best metal. If you will see your mirrors at home, it is polished by silver layer at the back. Yes, because bacha, iron will reflect light, but not that much. If you observe your mirrors at home, bacha, it will polish at the backside with silver. Yes, you're right. Is it clear? Amrita, I will let you know, silver is very expensive. I agree. But the polish of silver is not very expensive. It's just a thin layer. Nothing else. And many things are mixed into it. No worry, it's not so much expensive. Okay? Next is, an incident ray is what? Okay, the ray which falls on the mirror surface. Great. Very good, bacha. So I hope it is clear. The C option is correct. Sixth question. Which statement is correct about the laws of reflection? Now let me know. Which statement is correct? The incident ray, normal ray, and the reflected ray all lie in the same plane. The angle of reflection is always equal to the angle of incidence. The angle of incidence is equal to the angle formed by the normal ray. So the first option is correct, bacha. How, Amritya, it will be, bacha? Angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection, bacha. Not angle of reflection is always equal to angle I. Angel, try to understand, beta. If you remember, I will let you know with the proper information again. I think so you joined late, maybe. No issues. So, bacha, if you remember, this is a surface. The first light falls on it. That is an incident ray, beta. After that, the reflected ray will form, Angel. And this angle must be equal to this. No, Jatin, isn't same thing. Because in exam, never ever they give you the angle R. Try to understand. Yes, A answer is right. Because, bacha, angle is R is not equal to angle I. We can't say this. Because law of reflection is what? Angle I is equal to angle R. Seventh question, bacha. When a parallel beam of incident light is reflected as a parallel beam, yeah, Angad, you are right, bacha. But when we are writing somewhere, we are writing always this. You are right. If I put here, this is right. But in exam, they always give you angle incident because it will make first. Right? No one asks you, beta, if angle R is 30 degree, what will be the angle I? Because firstly, we will count which angle? Angle incidence. Because if angle incidence will not form, angle reflection will also not form. Is it clear? Okay, great. When a beam, parallel beam of incident light is reflected as a parallel beam in one direction, this reflection is called as regular reflection. Very good. Great. Eighth is, bacha, anything which gives out light rays is called anything which gives out a light rays is called a source. Very good. A object. Great, Shrivansh. Angad, very good. Ninth question. We see the image of our face when we look into the mirror. It is due to interference, diffraction, polarization, reflection. Great. The last question is, the image formed on a cinema screen is an example of real image, virtual image, point image, plain image. Yes, it is a virtual image. Great. Good. So, bacha, I hope it is clear with you all. What is light? Nature of light? Laws of reflection and reflection? No, bachi, not. The image formed on a cinema screen is an example of. Yes, bacha, it is an example of real image. You are right. Because virtual we are. I read it here like a mirror image. So that's why I told virtual. It's a real image, bacha. You are right. I read it that a mirror. So that's why I told you virtual. No, Ritik, real image is not always tilted, bacha. Real image is what we are able to see in our screen. Like we are watching any program, any TV reality program on the television, that is a real image. The virtual image is that which we are seeing in a mirror. That is a later inverted. Yes, Angel, I will. If you remember, I'll discuss with you light. Light is a source of energy. Its nature is wave and particle. Right? We explained you this. Yes, Angad, you are right. Then, bacha, reflection of light, laws of reflection, that angle I equals to angle R, and angle, the incident ray, the reflected ray, and the normal ray all lie on the same plane. Yes, Mikul, you are right. Is it clear till now how the image formed in plane mirror? How image formed in front of plane mirror? It is laterally inverted. Everything is clear, bacha, so that I will wind up this class today. Any doubt in your mind, if you have, please let me know first.
Yeah, and I believe, ma'am, I think this is going to be again taught in the regular class, right? When we start the regular classes. Okay, guys, so, yeah. So, I think, Angel, I think this is going to be taught again in the class. So, don't worry, because this is just a demo. It is just to give a flavor of the kind of classes which are going to happen. And in case you want to receive today's assignment, please WhatsApp at the number that Rashmi is going to be sharing. So how was the class, guys? Can I see people? Did you like the class? Okay, Aditya, thanks. Mikul, Sachi, thanks. Okay, I think we have wonderful set of people. I think I also felt that we had a pretty bright class also. I think pretty good interaction, right?
Interactive class, we can
say. Okay, yeah, no, I think it was pretty good. So guys, I think we are going to start. Aarti, what date are we starting this class?
22nd July.
So 22nd July, right? So we are starting in the exactly a week after.
It's a Wednesday.
So it's a Wednesday again. Mm-hmm. So guys, I think, few things. One, I think if you want to receive today's assignment or video, please WhatsApp us your details, just the student name, class, and the session that you have attended, right? So you attended today, the science session. So that we would know that you are from class 8 science, we'll be able to share the details. Okay. Second is that I think Rashmi has also already shared the payment link. So you can make the payment using this link. Sir, I messaged for maths class and I didn't receive. Okay. Now you should have received that, Amartya. So there's absolutely no reason why you should not receive the assignments for mathematics. So just, I think, WhatsApp at that number and we would be able to share that again. Yes, this is definitely not free. So only the demo part is free. And the regular classes that we are going to have from 22nd, they are definitely paid classes. Okay. Any other further questions?
Yeah, sir. One question on timing is coming. 2-3 students asked about the timing again.
So timing is going to be exactly as today. So it is going to be from 5:30 to 6:45. Okay, and I think in terms of the days, it is going to take place on Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday. Okay, so we are going to have three classes in a week, Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday. And this is going to be almost a 20 weeks program. We are not going to be sharing any books. We are going to be sharing reading notes. And we would be sharing exercises after every class, which you would have to study at home or solve at home. Okay, any other questions? We would be able to recommend some of the books. I think there are some standard books which are already there. So, which I think obviously, which can be taken along with these classes. And in case you have any doubts from the books, you can as well discuss that with your ma'am. No, it's not alternate classes, Shreyans. This is on Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday. It's not on Friday. It is on Saturday. Sir, there are classes of mathematics and science on the same day. No, for class 8, the classes are going to take place on Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. So it's not on the same day. Only Saturday class is going to be on the same day. But there's no overlap typings because yeah. Mathematics class will take place on 7 o'clock. Okay. Okay, guys. So what we'll do is we'll actually end the session in case there are no further queries. But I think one final comment from my side. See, class 8 is a time when your concepts have to be definitely very clear. This is also a stepping stone to the higher grades, which is class 9th and above. And I think again, a lot of you may be appearing for competitive, basically the entrance exams conducted by FITG or Akash or some of these. So what we have realized is that I think a lot of people get a scholarship based on the performance that you have. Most of these exams take place anywhere between Amartya, okay, you're attending FITG, so very good. So a lot of these entrance exams take place between December to February, which will take place next year or December this year. So we have seen that people who are prepared well, because preparing for Olympiads will also mean that you're studying a lot of concepts from higher grades, especially class 9th and class 10th. And a lot of these concepts are very useful for some of these entrance exams also. So people tend to get a better scholarship in case they know some of these advanced concepts. Plus, obviously, the more important part is the performance in the Olympiad exams. So you can do well. Okay, so I think we'll fees for mathematics classes. So there's a question from Aditya. So it's exactly the same as the science class. It is 9,990 rupees. Again, once you visit the link, you would be able to find the details for mathematics as well as science. Okay. Okay, guys, thanks a lot. And you were a wonderful audience. And I think it was a great interaction, Bakshish. So I think we had a very active participation from students. So thanks a lot. Bye-bye.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, guys. I'll see you in the class.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye.